Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today we're going to start a HP, and I'm going to use Monport 40 watts laser engraver to take a closer look of the circuitry, and I'm trying to reverse engineering the electronic part of this printhead. At first, we're going to look at how many types of components we have, so we're going to pay attention to the markings. TPs means test point. And this test point 19, so we're going to write it on the paper. We're going to write the largest number, so we know how many test points we have. And now we look at the other kind of components. And the J is FFC connectors. And R is resistor. And this J7K33800087 is the HP part number. And here's the J5 that's covered by this glue seal. I'm just going to write down the largest number rather than write down each individual point. C is for capacitors. It can be as big as those two, or if you see there's one deep inside, it can be little as that little thing hiding in between them. See that? That's a C2. And this big U1, the unit 1, is the timing encoder. The other is a timing scale, or we call it the timing belt. HP doesn't really want you to mess with their printers, so they have a special screw, and this one uses a T6. Just go to bchtechnology.com and type in T6. And here's a pair of T10 and T6. Let's see what we have in the back. Q is normally used for a transistor, so we have a Q1. Say 10, that means we have at least 10 capacitors. Here's the back of the encoder. Those four are marked here. Register, capacitor, and resistor. And let's take what this U2 is. And so it's LM358. And Google it, you're gonna find is 8 signal amplifier. And on the datasheet, you can find out what each pin is and how to test it. I'm going to not cover here. And if you need it, just leave a comment so I may shoot another video, show you how to troubleshoot it. So here I make a list of the parts and what's their maximum number. And next, we're going to remove this PCB board from this ribbon. And now this cable can be detached. And now just create a spreadsheet and type in all the components and what kind of component it is. And later on, we're going to test each component, fill in the data. Now we need to remove all the components. And if you have a desolder, you can use that. Or like I prefer, use a heat gun. We have so many components to remove and test. It's just easier to use a heat gun to heat up the whole board and just take them off. Just want to show you the physical part of the printhead. You can just get a flathead screwdriver and that can separate them. They just glue down by the same kind of glue they had. And you can see here's the ink delivery system. And after the ink is delivered, there are three holes to the collar nozzles. And the one hole is the really long one is for the black. I'm going to use a Monport laser engraver to cut it open in the next video. And this video, we're going to only focus on the electronic part. So we have this PCB board, and we have the picture of all the marks. However, the much of it is underneath this green coating. It's really hard to tell which one is connected to which. The laser engraver can remove a thin layer out of anything, almost anything. And that's what we plan to use to remove this layer and give us a better idea what's underneath. So in the labber, we draw a rectangle. Then we go here to change the size of the rectangle. Make sure to click the padlock to make sure it's unlocked. Otherwise, it's going to keep its ratio. Then we draw a smaller rectangle and line it up. Then we use these two to make a combination of the two shapes we just made. And this is the exact shape of our PCB board. Change the layer type to fill and the power to be 30%. I have another video show you how to set it up. I'm going to put a piece of paper on the platform and cut the outline and put a PCB board on it. As in the previous video, I showed how I set it up the air assist for this one. And because this is a burning PCB board, it's very important to have a good air vent. And you can see, if you see my previous video, it directly goes to an exhaust fan. And you can see the smoke here, and it all sucked out. I can actually open the cover and burn it without even smelling it. So we set the power to be 30% because we only want to burn the top layer of this PCB board and then reveal what's underneath. Therefore, when we draw the diagrams or we draw the schemas, it's easier for us to see the connection here. And you can see, without burning this off, it's really hard to tell the connection. This is so pretty, so I'm actually thinking make some merch out of it. Antique looking is so neat. So maybe embedded into a epoxy or something. If you want, you can just draw a square or a rectangle and put this thing in. However, it's going to take a longer time because you're burning more things you don't have to burn, and eventually it's going to cost you more time. Also, if you, like me, have a whole bunch of them, a little bit of time adds up a lot. And also notice it's going to burn the marks off, so you won't have any marks. And so next video, I'm going to show you how to import this into a free software called KiCad. With KiCad, we can look at this board and look at the photos that we take, put them together, and make a schema out of it. For the ribbon, there will be a shining side. Do not burn on the shining side. Let me show you, if you burn the shining side, you're going to see it just warp up. And so that part have a thicker coating, so you do not want to burn this part. Instead, if you flip over the other side, it will have glue, will look like dirty, and burn on this side. And remove the glue as much as possible with your finger, and then just start burning it. You're going to see it's going to look like charcoal. Don't worry about it. Just let it burn, and then we'll clean it up. The glue will have lots of smoke, so that's why you'll need to clean up afterwards. Just get a piece of dry paper towel and start rubbing it. If you have like a 2000 grit or like 8000 grit sandpaper, that's even better. And you can burn like a 2-3 layers off, so that will make it really nice and really shiny. Now we can clearly see all the connections. Again, next video, I'm going to draw a diagram with a KiCad. Then you'll understand the in and out of the Printhead, and you can design your own board, and also you can drive the Printhead with other programs or other printers you want to make. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us www.bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.